This is India's first Snapdragon 8 Elite phone. This is the first phone with Dimensity 9400. And this is the best iPhone that Apple has ever made. I think you already know where I'm going with this, don't you? Okay, so this is the realme GT7 Pro and it's going to be India's first Snapdragon 8 Elite phone. And I know you must be having a lot of questions about this new processor. Does it actually reach the 3 million mark in AnTuTu? How is the gaming performance? Does it overheat? And finally, how does it compare against the competition? In this video, I'll answer all your questions. So hit the like button and let's get started. First of all, let's understand the chipset better. It is called the Snapdragon 8 Elite because they're now using the Orion cores that we first saw on the Snapdragon X Elite laptops. Yes, we are now getting laptop level CPUs on a phone. There are 8 Orion cores with 2 of them clocked at 4.32 GHz and 6 at 3.53 GHz. The clock speeds are much higher compared to 8 Gen 3, Dimensity 9400 and even A18 Pro. Plus the GPU is upgraded this time along with a new AI engine. On paper, it's definitely the best you can get. Let's see how things pan out in benchmarks and day-to-day usage. Benchmarks first. We are running all these tests on the Indian unit of realme GT7 Pro, Chinese variant of vivo X200 Pro Mini, and iPhone 16 Pro Max with 8GB RAM and 1TB storage of God knows what kind. Okay, so in AnTuTu, I was hoping to take a screenshot of 3 million, but that never happened. And the best that I could get was 2.75 million, which is still a 25% improvement from last year's 8 Gen 3, and it's also slightly higher compared to Dimensity 9400. And yeah, Snapdragon also runs a bit cooler compared to Dimensity. In Geekbench, Apple's A18 Pro takes the lead in single cores, but with 8 performance cores this time, Snapdragon 8 Elite beat each one of them in the multi-core scores. Dimensity 9400 also didn't put up much of a fight here. I also ran CPU throttling tests to check the sustained performance on this phone, and in 15 minutes 20 threads test, the phone throttled down to 74%, and in 60 minutes 100 threads test, it went down to 77%. Now, in comparison to 8 Gen 3, it doesn't really feel like an improvement because we saw better numbers there. But if you compare it with Dimensity 9400, where it goes down to 60%, it's still better. Plus, the temperatures also don't cross 40 degrees, which is good. Now that we're done with the CPU benchmarks, let's see how much of an improvement does the new GPU brings. In Geekbench GPU, the scores have improved compared to 8 Gen 3, but Dimensity 9400 is slightly ahead this time in both OpenCL and Vulkan, but things change in 3DMark. In Wildlife Extreme Stress Test, which loops a 20 minutes GPU test, the 8 Elite scores a best score of 6300 and the stability was also at 83%, which is the best compared to both 9400 and A18 Pro. But the temperatures were also the highest, not uncomfortably high though. By the way, I also want to point it out that even the lowest scores of 8 Elite is higher compared to the highest scores of A18 Pro, which is quite good to be honest. And even though Dimensity scores an impressive 6100, it has a stability of only 55%, which is kind of a bummer. Lastly, in PCMark battery test, the phone scores an impressive 20 hours 45 minutes. So all in all, 8 Elite does not score as good as advertised, but it's still a huge improvement over 8 Gen 3. But things were totally different when I tested it for the first time. I say this because when we ran AnTuTu for the first time on this phone, although it was reaching 2.6 million, but it was reaching 47 degrees. And not just that, it even crossed 50 degrees in 3DMark and was also crashing in between, which was very surprising. In fact, we still couldn't run AiTuTu and the Geekbench AI results are terribly low, but it's not that the processor isn't capable of, it has something to do with the device. Because when we restarted the phone and reset it, most of the benchmarks started giving expected results. So yeah, 8 Elite is definitely a solid upgrade. But now, let's see how it does in gaming, because that's the actual benchmark, isn't it? First of all, in BGMI and COD Mobile, the phone supports maximum graphic as expected, and even after 15 minutes of gameplay, the phone was around 37 to 38 degrees. In Warzone, the phone supports peak graphics and throughout 15 minutes of gameplay, the FPS was solid 60 and it was running pretty cool too, which is very impressive. Another demanding game that I tested is Arena Breakout, where it supports Ultra HD graphics with 120 FPS and the game looked gorgeous with max graphics and ray tracing support. Lastly, in Genshin, the gameplay was smooth and the phone barely touched 40 degrees in 15 minutes of gameplay, but what's even more impressive are the gaming features. With UHD graphics, the render resolution increases, but the difference is noticeable only if you are a hardcore Genshin player. Plus, you also get Hyper HDR, AI Super Resolution, and Frame Plus, which gets you 120 FPS even in Genshin, but do note that these gaming features are realme specific. Overall, in terms of gaming, 8 Elite performs really well, there were no issues whatsoever, and the temperatures were always in control. Apart from benchmarks and gaming, I'm finding the phone very smooth to use in day-to-day usage as well. I really can't talk much about the phone because apart from the performance, everything else is still under embargo. But do subscribe for the full video because it's coming coming really soon. Now, to conclude things, 8 Elite is definitely a solid upgrade over 8 Gen 3, although it's not as good as advertised, but it's still a very good upgrade. That's it from my side. In case you have any questions about Snapdragon 8 Elite or Dimensity 9400, ask us in comments and we'll answer those. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.